world always seems quieter when it snows.
Did you need something?
Thank you.
Okay. Maybe it's time to get everyone together so Tilda can brief us. But is there anything I should handle before that? There we go. All drones are reconnected to the dome now. Thank you. find a spot for you to roost.
I've heard of you, Outlander. Your exploits must require supplies.
A good warrior cares for her equipment.
Honor and strength.
Speak for honor.
May your enemies fall.
Today.
What did Regala think she could achieve? Where do we start with cleaning up this...
That should nourish any warrior.
Achoo.
Walk with strength.
Walk in the light of the vision.
Outlander, are you in need
Why
of supplies?
Why is the Outlander leaping around?
You'll be back soon. I'm sure of it. Next time, I will take your shards.
Careful now.
Thank you.
honor and strength.
Your enemy is mine.
Good day, champion.
Hail, Hikaru's champion!
Go with honor. You fought well.
Show me your medals, champion.
Champion.
And I'll show you looking for a challenge? The clan lands. Ready to test your skills in the arena?
focus display is distorted.
Thank you.
exciting.
Our soldiers won't forget that fight easily.
Catching snowflakes on my lashes. Okay, maybe it's time to get everyone together so Tilda can brief us. But is there anything I should handle before that? All right, people. I need you up in the control room, right away. Okay, everyone. We all know what's at stake. Beta, Gaia. Not to mention life on Earth. Now, it might seem like the Zeniths are invincible, but they're not. We've got what it takes to break into their base and defeat them. We even have one of them on our side. Tilda, show us the base.
It is constructed atop the ruins of an ancient military facility on an island to the southwest. I can get us inside. To this location. Undetected.
How exactly?
You'll know when you need to. Once inside, our goal will be this structure. The launch tower. Gaia and Beta are being held at the top. But along the way, we will face overwhelming resistance. Most importantly, from Gerard, Eric, and the others. But also...
Once I take away their shields, we should be able to deal with them. But it will be easier to deploy the device if someone else is carrying it. I'll need a strong back.
Carry stuff? Yeah, I can do that.
Even if your device works, there will still be Spectre drones, scores of them.
If only we had an army to fight them.
I've got that under control. You'll know when you need to. All right. We'll meet up again just before we go in. Where's the best place to rendezvous?
On the coast, just across from the island. Once there, I'll show you the way.
Okay. I'll let you know when I arrive at the rendezvous point. And then you can join me. In the meantime, do whatever you need to prepare. Understood? You two? A minute? Tilda helped me get in touch with Beta, and she told me something important. There's an installation inside the base. It's called a regulator. Here. Once we're inside, I need you two to split off from everyone else and destroy it. So you'll have to bring explosives. This will help stop the drones. Everything depends on it. Are you with me? After that, I want you to find a way to infiltrate the Zenith network.
How?
Go over all the data that Beta left behind. She knew how to do it, I'm sure of that.
All right, but... why? What am I trying to do?
Find information about Zenith. Anything Tilda's not telling us. Silence is right about one thing. There's no way we can take her on her word.
I'll do my best.
Keep her safe, okay?
On my life.
Remember, we need to get Sylan's weapon to the Zenith base intact if we want to take their shields down.
I'll be gentle with it, I promise.
Good.
Aloy, aren't we meeting at the beach near the Zenith base?
We are. I just wanted to check in on everyone first. We're finally doing this.
Never thought I'd be off on a mission to take down a bunch of immortals from the stars. I can hear the drinking songs already.
If that one's not working right, you can have one of my spare focuses, you know.
Yeah, little bugger's got some personality, that's all. This saved my butt a couple of times now. It wouldn't feel right to leave it behind. You know, besides, it goes with my outfit.
Wouldn't want to spoil your look. Farrell made the right call, you know, bringing you here.
Thanks. Yeah, Varl. You know, I never knew he had a sister. I found out a few days before you guys went to Gemini. I was, to be honest, I was terrified I'd screw up the mission somehow. So he sat me down for a drink. Just one, mind you. And we talked about family. Vala, Ursa, loss and revenge. How you helped us.
You know, we never did get that drink you promised back in the Embrace. And you never told me exactly how your sister escaped the Mad Sun King.
I guess we never got around to it. World ending and all. No time like the present, though. If you're up for it.
You think it's time for us to finally have that drink?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, of course. Oh.
So, how did Ursa escape Mad Sun King Jaron's palace?
First she had to survive the Sun Ring. See, during the war, the Karja threw a prisoner a day in there. And, you know, for what? To die as sacrifices, fighting machines in a pit. Thinking somehow that was gonna appease all the other deranged machines in the world? Ha! And when it was Ursa's turn, the Karja thought she'd go down if they threw a big machine at her.
Oh, but she didn't.
Yeah, she defeated all of them. Even got some of Jaron's kestrels for good measure. And the Mad Sun King was impressed, I guess. Thought it'd be funny to have her run around his palace as a servant. He enjoyed humiliating her that way.
I remember you telling me something about that. That's how she met Avad. He helped her escape.
Yeah, but what no Karja scroll will ever tell you is how the young prince snuck Ursa out of the palace. He knew their best chance was to get Ursa to blend in, so he got her everything she needed to disguise herself as a Karja noblewoman. Yeah, perfumes, veils, and all.
I get the feeling she wasn't too happy with that.
Oh, man. Ursa would have rather fought her way out of that palace with her bare hands than put on all of that Karja eye paint. But Avad insisted it was the only way, so she agreed under one condition. Avad had to dress up as well.
She made Avad dress up like a noblewoman?
As perfumed and powdered as a babe. Ursa said he looked better like that than he ever did in a crown.
That would, definitely make for an interesting sight.
Oh, it worked like a charm, too. Not only did they make it out of the palace, they paid a traveling merchant to get Ursa to the border, and none were the wiser.
You were right. That was a story best told over a drink.
All good stories are.
guess I should get going.
I'll see you at the rendezvous point. With my hammer ready.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
Aloy, we're ready to meet you at the rendezvous point whenever you call.
Fighting the Xenos isn't going to be easy.
Nothing you do ever is. At least, now you don't have to do it alone.
Thanks. Everyone here, training, working together. If it weren't for Varl, none of it would have happened.
You know, there was this one night, right before Varl left with you to go to Gemini. He realized I was having trouble sleeping. I was nervous about the mission. To be honest, I think we both were. So, he asked me to join him in Gaia's dome. He brought up this hologram of Earth that you two found back in the Zenith launch facility. We sat there, just looking at it. I thought about how Plainsong was just a speck on that great sphere. How every corner of it must be teeming with life. And any fears I had about our mission were gone. I miss him terribly.
I know. You and Aaron seem to be on better terms now.
He may have terrible taste in music, but he did apologize for mocking my tribe. And that ale he keeps raving about isn't half bad. I still plan on beating that stubborn face of his to break our sparring stalemate.
Try not to hurt him too bad. I should go. I'll let you know when I'm ready to head to the base.
Before you do, there is one favor I would ask of you.
What is it?
You placed this focus in my care, and gave me the highest calling an Utaru has ever known. If I should fall in battle, I'd like you to be the one to bury my seed pouch. For the both of us.
So,
make sure you stay alive to do so.
Let's just try to all come back home. Okay? Nervous?
I'd be lying if I said I'm not slightly apprehensive.
The plan will work if we all focus on our assignments.
Right.
The rest of us should be enough of a distraction to the Zeniths for you to hack into their network undetected. But you'll have to be quick in case they do.
What exactly do you expect me to find, Aloy?
I don't know. The truth. If we're lucky. Once all this is over, will you go back across the ocean?
I don't know. The more I think about it, the more worried I become. If I go back, I don't even know if they'd let me keep this focus you gave me, or what they'd do to me for reading what is clearly forbidden data. Even if I somehow were allowed to carry on my duties as a diviner, would I be willing to let the truths I've learned about the ancestors be buried away by the Board of Overseers? Would I dare challenge them and risk my family's safety? Or losing Federa?
Who's this Federa you mentioned?
She is another diviner. One of our best. We used to be rivals at the academy. I hated her guts. But apparently there is a fine line between hate and love. We became very close, and then I was assigned to the expedition. She promised she'd wait for me, no matter how long it took.
Well, that was smart of her. She won't do any better.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
I do. I want you to know I'm glad you're with us, Alva.
Whatever happens, I'm grateful that the legacy brought us together. I never thought I'd get to actually meet an ancestor.
Come on, do I look that old? Katala will protect you inside the Zenith base.
I'm not afraid. I know Katala will fulfill his duty, as will I. If we die doing so, at least it'll be alongside a friend.
I'd rather you both stay alive, if you don't mind.
We'll try and keep that in mind.
Who's this Federa you mentioned?
She is another diviner. One of our best. We used to be rivals at the Academy. I hated her guts. But apparently there's a fine line between hate and love. We became very close, and then I was assigned to the expedition. She promised she'd wait for me, no matter how long it took.
Well, that was smart of her. She won't do any better.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
I do. I need to get going.
I'll be at the rendezvous point. May truth lead us to victory.
Did you need something? Something else?
Tell me about the weapon. How does it work?
I've upgraded the delivery system. It now emits a wave-like effect covering a significant distance.
That doesn't fully answer my question.
No, but I'd be a fool to reveal its inner workings. After all, why did you withhold your plan for dealing with the Zenith drones? Yes, even you can appreciate the value of secrecy when warranted. Suffice it to say that the weapon will work. The intricacies of how is knowledge that is mine alone.
I'll be going.
As you wish.
So, how are we feeling about the mission?
I do not know everything that you have planned, but it doesn't matter. All that remains is to follow you to the end, whatever that will be.
Thank you, Katala. I'm glad all this brought us together.
You brought us together, and I am grateful too. Oh, and by the way, I was hoping now would be a good time to go back to the Tremortusk site and test my new arm. Before we leave on our mission.
Right. I'll let you know when I can make my way there.
Thank you.
Now that training time is over, what's on your mind?
The Bulwark, the Kulrut, and how we need another miracle if we're to survive the Zenith base.
I'll try not to let you down.
I know you will not.
We didn't really get to talk about what happened at Gemini.
There was nothing more to say. If he were to Nokth, Varl's bravery would have earned him sacred burial at the Grove, among the most distinguished of our tribe's warriors. His deeds were worthy of the Ten. When the fight is done, I will have the Inkers etch his memory on my skin, so that it may live on.
I'm sure he'd be honored. I bet people are curious about that new arm of yours.
None more than our Quen ally, I assure you. She couldn't wait to take it apart and figure out how it works. I gave her the data I used to build the thing, hoping that would satisfy her curiosity instead.
Good luck with that. I'll see you soon, then.
It will be my honor.
There you are. Would you like to continue our chat?
Why do you think Elizabeth pulled away?
I've wondered that for 1,000 years. She was brilliant, visionary. She cared so deeply for the world, for the betterment of humanity. But it also felt like she kept everyone at arm's length, including me. She never wanted to share her burdens. I think, in the end, she had a core that she never let anyone be part of. Sometimes I wonder if anyone really knew her.
I should be going.
I'll be making final preparations.
What do you want?
Come to rattle the cage.
Are you really going to fight alongside me?
I have no reason to betray you.
Really?
I failed to kill Hakaro. Failed to eliminate you. No Tanakhth would follow me now. The Karja remain out of my reach, cowering behind their walls. All I have left are the screams of those long dead and unending rage. So show me where to bury it.
I need to be going.
Yes, enough talking.
It'd be harder to see in the snow. should fly lower. There. Rendezvous point. I should take care of everything I can before calling in the others to attack the Zenith base. Okay, everyone. I'm at the rendezvous point. It's time to rescue Beta and Gaia.
Understood, Aloy. We're on our way.
Hmm.
Aloy.
Where are the others?
Not far behind.
Egghead here couldn't stand traveling with the pack.
Are we all here? Then let's begin.
A tunnel.
An ancient escape route from the ruins on the island. When I realized it ran all the way across the water, I thought it might prove useful to come and go undetected. So I concealed it from the others. Shall we?
I wish there was a less pungent way to get way inside the base.
Agreed.
There's the launch tower. That plane offers a little cover, so the only viable path is through there. There will be specters guarding it, and many more can be deployed from those hangars.
All right. Alva, Catalo, get to it.
Where are they going?
Somewhere important. Erend, you're with me. You guys, take the high ground in case we need covering fire.
Tactically sound, I suppose. What will she do?
There's a sensor node nearby. If I hack into it, I should be able to scramble the network and keep you undetected. But not for long.
Then we should proceed.
One more thing. Open up the channel to Beta. Audio only.
Aloy.
We're here. And we're coming for you. You know what to do, right?
As long as you hold up your end.
We will. See you soon.
Be careful.
Let's go.
Get to the launch tower as quickly as possible. I'll do my best to conceal our intrusion.
sectors ahead.
Company. Follow my lead.
That's what I do.
Shatter that machine. Bottoms up. And now's a good time to hit it.
Looks like it's strong against shock damage.
Anytime you're ready. I'll follow you in.
Eyes up, make it brittle.
Not fear, but it'll do.
Yeah, I think we got it.
I think you're right.
Find anything?
Yeah.
What's in this backpack, Metal Bricks?
Aloy, Alva and I are closing in on the regulator.
Keep me posted.
It's creepy in here.
Don't worry. I'll protect you.
I wish I had a glider. I guess I'll find another way across. Can we please leave the cave now?
There's a lot of dead machines on this island.
We killed a great many when we landed here. Their salvage may prove useful to you now.
Another Spectre.
Sneak or fight. You choose. Any good loot?
A little.
We should move on. Whoa. Next time I get it.
Yet?
Yeah. Yeah! Oh. Clear those weeds!
Line cutter's working. We're through.
Well, I'll just leave it here then. Live long, kill your enemy.
Inspectors are good sport!
We can take this one, Aloy! Keep moving!
Stormbird carcass should get us over the gap.
I hate Stormbirds. But I guess that dead one's handy enough. Hey, you remember the good old days when our only worry was whether Meridian would be destroyed? You know, instead of the whole world?
Oh, yeah. Good times.
more Spectres. I'll attack when you do. Makes a nice target.
Push on.
What do you get?
Just some parts. Here, up this rock. We're gonna have to climb around this corner.
Well, I'll try not to complain.
I can see the way forward.
Going as fast as we can. You all right?
Sort of.
Looks like the others have things under control.
Some
Come on, up the slab.
Aloy, Alva and I are in position.
Do it. Blow the regulator.
A moment while I ignite the charges.
Alva and Catalo did their job. Now it's Beta's turn.
Aloy? I think we're in trouble.
Whatever you plan to do to stop those specters, you better do it now.
I'm not doing anything. Beta will. She just needs a little time.
Time that we don't have.
What is that?
Our army.
I think you got their attention.
Very clever. Had Beta inject Hephaestus into the base's printer matrix.
Which is faster and more powerful than any cauldron.
Now it can crank out machines to its heart's content. The launch tower before this whole place becomes a war zone.
Your maneuver, as clever as it is, means that Hephaestus has escaped containment. It will no doubt feed back to the Cauldron network.
We grabbed it once, we'll get it again.
Or we'll find a way to replicate its functionality, perhaps. The empowered database.
We don't make it. I just have one regret.
What is it?
We had to do all this climbing.
That big rock might give us a bridge to get up and through.
Gotcha.
Not all the specters are fighting our machines.
Ah, that would have made it nice and easy. Hit it while it's broke. You got its weak spot. Oh, I heard that crunch from here. This thing with acid.
Zo and Baldi are fighting another Spectre up there.
I think they can handle it.
Let's go.
This way.
Big jump. To the right, I think.
To the left.
You can get to the launch tower through the hangar up ahead. I'm heading over to join you now.
The hangar's in bad shape, but I can see the way in. Hurry, Aloy!
Look at all this Zenith space stuff.
This is a find.
Let's go!
This way, demon! Ah!
Gala returned peacefully to the cycle.
She cared nothing for peace.
At least she died on her own terms. Now is your moment.
Oblivion draws no such distinctions.
That's cold. Are you sure you're not a Zenith?
Aloy, it's been intense, but Cthulhu got me to a network node. I'm trying to get in.
Keep at it. We're almost to the tower.
Now we know who's been causing all the fuss. Tilda's little pet.
Silence! Zenith's inbound. Can we drop their shields, please?
I'm powering it up.
Stay still.
This is pointless! You can't hurt us. Face it. You're worms that ooze through the cracks into our basement.
Silence?
One moment more.
But I might just spare you if you give up Tilda. I think it's safe to say she's forfeited her share of our operation. Permanently.
There.
No? Nothing. Fine. All right, people. Light 'em up! Are we supposed to be scared?
Escape. It won't take long before he preps the shuttle for launch. Then he'll be able to take Beta and Gaia into orbit and onto the Odyssey beyond our reach.
We gotta go through there?
I fail to see another option.
Then we'll carve a path. Ready?
Gotta get to the top of the tower and free Beta. An elevator. Promising.
We got some unfinished business, little girl.
I don't need a shield to take you out.
Trust me, you're gonna wish you had one.
You ready, little mouse?
Yeah.
Keep me on my feet. You're done for!
Now we're having fun, right?
You okay?
I will be. In time. Go. Rescue your sister. I'll regroup with the others and make sure they're all right.
Better take the lift. Looks like the machines and specters have almost wiped each other out. Where was that?
Aloy, Gerard just activated the self-destruct failsafe on the printing matrix. He's taking control of a number of systems.
Including the lift?
I'm afraid so. He's restricted its access to the top. You'll have to climb from there. I have to go. I almost have.
Aaron, is everyone all right down there?
Mostly. We're cleaning up the last few specters.
What about the Zeniths?
Dead, I think. Izo told me you got Eric. Good work.
Yeah. Thanks. I guess only Tilda and Gerard are left now.
Aloy, you there? Listen, I got into the network, but only for a minute before I was shut out. I found a bunch of flight plans and trajectories, as if the Zeniths were planning to leave Earth.
Doesn't make any sense.
I know, but there's more. The files I found have a lot of references to something called Nemesis. Whatever it is, the Zeniths are afraid of it.
Alva? Alva! What's going on here? Maybe Beta can help me figure it out. She's okay. Are you okay? Look, I know you've been through a lot, but you have to help me access the Zenith network. I need to see their files. Anything referring to the word Nemesis. Okay. Over there. The systems are down all over the base. I should be able to take advantage of... Yes, Nemesis. Here. There's something in deep space. It's following the Zeniths to Earth. Look. Escape vectors. Alva tried to warn me about this. The Zeniths aren't planning to stay here. It's a machine of some kind. Or a swarm of them. The energy readings are astronomical. Aloy, I don't think a natural disaster destroyed the Zenith colony on Sirius.
This thing did.
Earth isn't a new home for them. It's a way station. They're on the run.
I see you've been busy.
And you've been lying. Nemesis, what is it?
It is us. The minds of Far Zenith. Or failed copies of them, anyway. Back on Sirius, some of my peers weren't satisfied with physical immortality. They wanted digital transcendence. A way to upload their minds into any form, organic or mechanical. Nemesis was a failed experiment to that effect. Abandoned, but never erased. An immense database of our memories, emotions, and prejudices left to fester.
And it destroyed your colony?
We didn't realize it had gained sentience until it broke containment. It had everything it needed from our memories. Security protocols, system specs, override codes. It hacked everything before we knew what hit us. Then it took over our printing facilities, allowing it to gain any machine form it needed to wipe us out.
But why?
Imagine being trapped alone for decades with only the twisted echoes of megalomaniacs for company. It hates us for abandoning it to that prison. And now that it's free, it will do anything to destroy us, including denying us a safe harbor on Earth.
The extinction signal that woke Hades. You didn't send it. Nemesis did.
Finally, you understand. And when that failed, it launched from Sirius to finish the job itself. Which is why we must flee to a random planet circling a random star, somewhere it can never find us.
With Gaia, so you can build yourself a new world.
That's the plan. Even now. Earth is finished, Aloy. Nemesis will scour it of life to deny its creators a viable home. But Elizabeth's dream won't die. You'll come with me to the stars. And with Gaia, we'll create a new world. Together, where that monstrosity could never find us.
What? No.
I loved Elizabeth more than you could ever know. And I let her stay behind to die with the rest of humanity. A mistake I have regretted for 1,000 years. Now she stands before me again. Not some inferior copy, but her best possible self. So I'm not asking. You're coming with me. It may seem harsh now, but you'll forgive me in a few centuries.
You can't force me, Tilda. Your shield is gone.
I have something better. Spectre Prime. To me.
Take cover! Get to the door!
Serve me, Aloy. You can't wait.
No! I've heard that before.
Sticks and stones against the lightning. Oh!
knew you didn't truly want to hurt me.
I better scan that thing first.
She tried to take you. And she told you about Nemesis.
So you've known all along.
From Hades, yes. Along with data on how to circumvent the Zenith shields. Everything I did to create the Rebel Army was based on that knowledge. To reach this place, this moment.
And you couldn't just tell me?
Come now, Aloy. You're the last person to act sensibly in the face of impossible odds. When I learned of Nemesis from Hades, I saw the pieces on the board and how to play them. And in that same moment, I knew it was a game you would never play. That you would interfere and attempt to save the Tanakht. I was correct, to a point. You ruined my plans, but brought your own to fruition. The end result is the same. We're here. And now it's time for me to leave this doomed planet behind. To seize the Odyssey and the Apollo database. And begin a new chapter in my pursuit of knowledge, one with infinite possibilities. You can join me if you so desire. You've more than earned your place. Unlike Tilda, I'm extending a polite invitation.
You're going to just take off and abandon everything? Stay. Help me fight that thing.
Perhaps Tilda didn't adequately define the threat. Nemesis can't be stopped. It destroyed a highly advanced Zenith colony in a matter of hours. What hope does this primitive tribal Earth have? If you brought Gaia, you wouldn't be abandoning life. You'd be saving a seed for a new world. Just as Elizabeth did. It's the choice she made. The sacrifice of all that is for the hope of what might be. If she were here in your place, she would board that shuttle, Aloy.
Found her.
Is she hurt?
Still on her feet.
Thank the Ten.
Goodbye, Silence.
She looks okay.
She looks victorious.
As always.
Aloy. You did it.
Where's he going?
As far away as anyone can go.
Oh. Are you sure?
You're staying.
For a time. You people are going to need all of the help you can get.
Does anyone else need a drink?
Not if it's that ale of yours.
I'd be fine with a nap.
Excellent idea.
I hope it's really over this time.
There's another battle ahead, Elizabeth. Very different than the one you fought. It's not about the distant hope of creating a new world. It's about preserving the one we have. My friends have a new mission. To spread the word and ask for help. They've taken it in stride. I think it's because they've always known what I've only just started to understand. That the people of this world have the strength to fight any battle. The ingenuity to solve any problem. The courage to overcome any obstacle. And the resilience. Rise after any setback. As for me, I can't say I'm not afraid. What lies ahead will be harder than anything we've faced before. But I know I can put the fear aside. Because for the first time in my life, I feel like I'm not alone.
It's gone so somber. These words don't seem like mine, but the iron won't subside. No matter what I try.
gardens are full of flowers. My ears are full of songs. My heart is sad enough. I'd rather just be wrong. I listen when you talk. Your words all make sense. But underneath,
you're